I have six numbers here, and you see that five of them are irrational. They involve the square root of a non-perfect square. And my goal, or our goal in this video, is without a calculator, see if we can sort these numbers from least to greatest. And like always, pause this video and see if you can do that. So I'll give you a hint. The hint is, well, it's very hard without a calculator. You know, square root of 2, it's going to be 1 point something something. Square root of 3 is going to be 1 point something something. How do we do this? Well, you just have to realize, if I have some number, let's say I have some number a that is greater than 0, and if we know that a is less than b, well, then a squared is going to be less than b squared. If one number, if one positive number is less than another positive number, then the square of this positive number is going to be less than the square of that number. So one thing that we could do when we are comparing all of these irrational numbers that involve square roots of non-perfect squares, well, let's compare their squares, because their squares are not going to be irrational numbers. It's going to be much easier to compare, and then we can order them. Because if we order the squares, then that'll tell us what happens if we order their square roots. So what am I talking about? Well, I'm just going to square each of these. So if I take this to the second power, this is going to be 4 square roots of 2 times 4 square roots of 2. You can change the order of multiplication. That's 4 times 4 times the square root of 2 times the square root of 2. Now 4 times 4 is 16. Square root of 2 times square root of 2, well, that's just going to be 2. So it's going to be 16 times 2, which is equal to 32. Now what about 2 square roots of 3? Well, same idea. It's 2, let's square it. Let's square it. And I'll do this one a little bit faster. So if we square 2 square roots of 3, this is going to be 2 squared times square root of 3 squared. So it's going to be 2 squared times the square root of 3 squared. Well, 2 squared is going to be 4. Square root of 3 squared is going to be 3. So this is going to be equal to, 12. That's this thing squared. And if this step seems a little bit confusing, if you have the product of two things raised to a power, that's the same thing as raising each of them to that power and then taking the product. And you can actually see, I kind of worked it out here, why that actually makes sense. Notice, when I just changed the order of multiplication, you had 4 times 4, or 4 squared, times square root of 2 squared, which is going to be 2. So let's keep doing that. So what is this value squared? Well, it's going to be 3 squared, which is 9, times square root of 2 squared, which is 2. 9 times 2 is 18. What's the square root of 17 squared? Well, that's just going to be 17. Do that in blue. This is just going to be 17. What is 3 square roots of 3 squared? Well, it's going to be 3 squared, which is 9, times square root of 3 squared. The square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is 3. So it's going to be 9 times 3, or 27. And what is 5 squared? Well, this is pretty straightforward. That's going to be 25. So let's order them from least to greatest. So which of them, when I square it, gives me the smallest value? Well, the small, compare 32 to 12 to 18 to 17 to 27 to 25. 12 is the smallest value. So if their square is the smallest, and these are all positive numbers, then this is going to be the smallest value out of all of them. So let me write that first. So 2 square roots of 3. So I've covered that one. Now what's next? Well, now I have this value. 17 is the next smallest square. So its square root is going to be the next smallest, or the next square root. So it's going to be 2 square roots of 3, then square root of 17. That is this one here. And then we go to 18. So if we look at its square root, with the numbers we were originally trying to sort, that'd be three square roots of 2. We got that one covered. Then the next one is going to be 25 when you look at the squares. So the next value out of our original set, the next largest one, is going to be 5. So then we get to 5. We've covered that one. Then the next one, let's see, we have 27 and 32 left. So the next largest one is going to be The 27 is the next largest square, so the next largest number out of the ones we care about is 3 square roots of 3. So 3 square roots of 3, we covered that one. And then we finish with, this is the largest value, 4 square roots of 2. 4 square roots of 2. And we're done. That was pretty neat. Without a calculator, we were able to sort these irrational numbers, these numbers. Well, not all of them are irrational, but the ones that involved a square root of something that is not a perfect square.